£47 million is spent every day on alcohol in Britain. More women are drinking, and while most do so in moderation, the number of women with a drink problem is on the increase. Research blames a number of factors. Women now make up 45% of the workforce, giving them more money and opportunity to drink. Relative to income, alcohol is cheaper than before the last war, and advertisers are accused of targeting women in their drink campaigns. But while the number of women alcoholics grows, the facilities to help them remain inadequate. A report out today reveals London has only 81 beds for drying out treatment, and of those, only 9 are set aside especially for women. The crisis means many desperate alcoholics can't get the help they need.
That they're left isolated from any sort of assistance. They're left to struggle along with the problem and no doubt get into worse problems, whether it's social in terms of the family, whether it's financial, or whether it's all the other sort of things that can happen to you as a result of drink.
At this centre in Islington, former alcoholics are being counselled as part of rehabilitation. But the unit can only accept acute cases who've already been through the detoxification process, and a delay for treatment can prove critical.
Well, it can mean that we lose the woman. Often women come here in crisis situation, it reaches the point that they can't go on. And they'll come here, and if they need detox and we can't get them in straight away, then they'll go away and maybe not come back. The immediate crisis will pass and they don't come back and we don't know what happens to them.
The exact scale of the problem is unclear. Researchers fear the true figure's hidden because most women don't know where to seek help. The Department of Health says it's carefully considering the report, but professionals warn that without immediate investment in better facilities, the problem can only get worse. Teresa Driscoll for Thames News.
Right. Oh, gosh,